Hello everyone. My name is Metin Torasoğlu. Today I will talk about shortly about precision agriculture and what are the benefits and also we will come back to the how to calculate the savings and money back period and so on. So I would like to shortly introduce what does it mean precision farming. So precision farming is relatively new and high technology driven farming practice, which may potentially improve resource of usage and reduce the environmental impacts of the arable crop production. So, historically, like before, field boundaries were often long natural soil boundaries leading to the small fields, which were treated homogeneously. And as the agricultural machinery was developed and grew even larger, fields were often combined and to allow for more efficient cultivation. And as a result, fields with varying properties were created, result in inefficiencies. And that's why precision farming, precision agriculture was developed to overcome these problems. So, precision agriculture, we are talking about into three topics. The one is a start point to start collect the data. So, data collection it simply can be start with the yield mapping and GPS, crop sensors, and protein sensors and nitrogen sensors, nitrogen map of the field. So this kind of sensors help us to collect data and as a next step to process them and to make a decision of about your farm. So as a global population, it's continued to grow and resources are becoming more exhausted and farmers are faced with the challenge for growing more, farmers need to use less. So for this reason, increasing the farm productivity in the area and better utilization of the farm resources. And also to support farmers, the sensors, data support farmers to measure all their aspects, business and from the soil and crop performance to financials. After all having an insights into data, it's crucial for increasing farmers' productivity, sustainability, and finally, of course, profit. And the next one is a technology applicator. So here, by the using collected gathered data, able to apply variable rate applications in the level of fertilizing, spraying, and irrigation, planting, and the other sowing applications. So here, the main purpose is to apply digital knowledge to the agricultural activities. So basically, the applicators are might be such as agricultural drones, variable rate applicators, variable rate machines, automatic steering tractors, autonomous vehicles. So these are all we call it the applicators. And the next one is there are some numbers of factors which is impact the yield and on the particular crop and on the particular field. So weather is one of the One of the factors that farmer cannot control, and but there is a little predictability as to how the season will turn out, and the weather may have a profound impact on both the quantity and quality of the yield. However, as an input into precision farming, like climate can be analyzed or also can be grouped into a number of possible seasons, like to use in the precision agriculture. And we are limited with the soil. We have a little control on the soil. So we cannot change the fertility of the soil, such as like a soil structure. But we can have some control like over the fertility status that we can achieve. So for example, we cannot choose particular field, but with the limits, we can achieve the higher fertility status by conserving humus or correcting the nitrogen status in the soil. And husbandry, we have a full control on the husbandry as a farmer. We can choose whatever we prefer to have the which plant on the field, and also how to treat the crop on the field depending on the field conditions, and also like a furthermore, like we have a full control over the different methods that it's about the timing and efficiency of the applications. And as a plant, we also have a fully control on this factor. We can choose between the crops like maize, sunflower, soybean, or winter wheat. So for the particular crop, we can choose particular variety suit to the our particular conditions. So like also we can choose row spacing, in row spacing, which is suit to the our farm management and the farm conditions. So here there are benefits. Actually, there are much more benefits which we can written here. It will take a lot of place, but in terms of money, precision agriculture, precision farming is increasing the yield by the increasing the efficient work on the field, and to use the field more regular in terms of to reducing overlaps and gaps and to reduce stress between the crops, and by applying the technology such as automatic steering. So we can increase the work efficiency. We can work with the low visibility conditions, and day and night we can use because in agriculture there's a seasonality. This means that we have a limited time to finish a job, finish the job on time. Pardon. And the other thing is that by the saving, we are reducing the production costs, and as well as amount of agrochemicals, and by the time saving, we are reducing the fuel consumption, and labor costs are also going to reduce. So actually, I am also a farmer. I started to use these systems like since 2 years, and it is a quite nice to have these systems because, there is a there, for example, for the mice crop, have a limited time, maximum 15 days because of the weather condition, climate conditions, we are limited. So just we are let the system do the job, driving, being operator, and we were focusing more about the implements work and efficiency of planting application. And the other hand, we didn't need a professional operator to drive the tractor. And also we started to keep the data of our farm, like in terms of to save data of inputs and the outputs. And in terms of ecology, definitely it's reducing the pollution and reducing the soil compaction by the reducing the field traffic, of course. And also it's a topic that we are saving natural sources. So how is it going? So did I cover all till this time? Didn't I mention as a benefit? Maybe you would like to add so on your comments on your on the chat, right?
Okay.
Okay, then if you will have any questions, please write on the chat. So after the calculation, we will answer your questions. So as I mentioned before, technology application. We will go further with the automatic steering tractors. And we have a main inputs on the farm operations, so seeds and the fertilizer, pesticides, energy, and the other such of nitrogen sampling laboratory, grain dryers, maybe these are all the inputs. And with the next slides, I'm going to show you calculation. But for this, I need to just stop sharing and reshare the file. So, do you see my screen well? Okay, so I assume that it's okay. And here we prepared a calculator, a sample of a 20 hectare field with the winter wheat production. So on the first table, we have a different machine type, like lower than 170 horsepower, and between 170-20 and between 200 and 300, and the larger tractor. And as a 20 hectare, as a sample, we just take the example of 250 field width, and the field length is 400 meter. And the first table, actually, to start calculation, we need to put the parameters. And also, before start the calculation, we need to make some measurements of your previous field operations. Because the one that to be able to calculate, so we need to calculate the overlapping on the column E and the row 3. This year we take as an average overlapping with the 3 meter of implement and also as a automatic steering solution overlapping is just 2 centimeter to use RTK correction signal. So as you see here in case effective working with the conventional farming it's a 2 meter and 83 centimeter and the automatic steering is a fix as a 2 meter and 98 centimeter. And the second table here, this is efficiency comparison between manual driving and the automatic steering. So as you see on the column C and row 12, the theoretical number of trucks should be 83, and with the 17 centimeter overlapping. And the number of tracks is increased to the 88 tracks. So, as a result, we see that there is a 5% efficiency difference compared to manual driving and automatic steering. And as a next calculation will be what about time saving and the headland turns? And again, we continue with the 3 meter implement rate, and our operating speed is at 2.2 meter second. And as an average to spend time for the every headland turn is at 25 seconds. And here, we are spending in total 2,083 seconds only for the headlamps. But when we talk about the automatic steering, to not obligate to turn from next path to path turn, then there is a quite big difference. So here, as we see, as a efficiency time saving, it's a approximately 6%. But these numbers are, if you see here, when the implement width is getting larger, and so the difference between manual driving and automatic steering is decreasing. So there are too many parameters is impacting the result of efficiency. So like the recommendation is that you need to measure all like clearly of your farming operation and the measurement of the overlaps or gaps. It might be much more precise calculations for your farm operations. And how you calculate this was about the difference between manual driving and the headland turns. And here is a real sample of winter wheat production. It was in Germany last winter season. And the all the numbers are actual. So we use these calculations are based on 1 hectare area, and we use 170 kilogram seeds, and as well as 175 kilogram urea and ammonium nitrate liquid fertilizer. And there are different type of pesticides. It's applied together. And here, and as another the topic, we have energy cost, and as a other, we have an interest rate, and nitrogen sample, and the grain drive. So first, I will go through the conventional growing. So as we see here, our net income was from the sales was 1,802 euros per hectare, and then we spend 117 liter of diesel for all farming operations. And our general production cost was 679 euros on the column F and row 35. So here we have a 1,122 euros gross margin. And also here we have information about working hours that we spend. Sorry. We spend 17.2 hours for this this work. And coming back to the automatic steering efficiency. So just I will go down to see the two difference. So by the improving 6% efficiency by the GPS, so we have a 646.91 euro production cost instead of 679. So this mean per hectare we save in total 122 euros. And as a summary table, as I mentioned, we have 122 euros margin per hectare, and we apply to the 20 hectare area, and in the total saving, 2,452 euros, and I referring as a automatic steering cost by the approximately 6,000 euros, and only by the 20 hectare on the winter crop, and the payback period will be 2.4 years, so it is almost 30 in 30 months. But as in detail, we save 11 hours of working time. And also, we save 150 liter of diesel, which is really quite good for the pollution and eco-friendly. And also, we see here that we save 15 liter of agro pesticides. It's eco-friendly. And in terms of fertilizer and the seeds, I see that we save 175 kilogram of the fertilizer and the 170 kilogram of seed. So this means from the 20 hectare, we save 1 hectare in terms of cost. And this is a simple calculation, of course, for the row crops. And actually, depending on your farming operations and what kind of crops you grow and how many times you do operations, which kind of implements with different implement weeds, these are all factors affecting the calculation table. What need to do is that if you use a different kind of for each implement, if there is a different parameter in terms of overlapping gaps need to be calculated and to make overall total and at the end and then you will see the final cost and payback period. So simply, when we look at the summary table, so only Because row crops are much more valuable and especially needed more automatic steering in terms of planting than inter-row cultivation and urea applicators and so on. So then the number of field operation, it is much more. And each operation, if you will save between 5% up to 15%, yeah, of course, there are super nice drivers. They are driving like RTK accuracy. I appreciate about their driving and their professionality, but in the average, and statistics shows that there are with the GPS system, usage of GPS system, it gives you benefit between 5 up to 15% of the increasing efficiency, yield, and saving from the inputs. So for the row crops, considering to all different kind of field operation, when you make it in total, it might be even. Of course, the field size is important and the number of fields. So as much as you have a larger field, so the payback period will be much more less. Maybe even less than a year. Maybe during the season, you will return your investment. Is there any question?
Thank you, Metin. I see that people are mostly asking about sharing this Excel document with them and also leaving, yes, talking about the joy of using it. yeah, I think we can continue. Thank you guys for messages.
Okay, so actually, just if you are fine with the all questions, because I'm going to stop sharing the tab with the calculation, and I will come back to the presentation. Okay, and we have a video that one of the biggest benefit of the using tractor auto steer system is comfort. So the health, comfort, it's the most important, and which really you cannot measure and probably calculate by money. So just I will quickly play the video. So as you see, you can enjoy for the other tasks and let the automatic steering operate the tractor. And for more videos, you are welcome to visit our YouTube channel. So, I hope till here we cover all of your expectations. And if you will have any questions, also you can contact us by email and for the other channels.
Yeah. Thanks, Metin. I would like to add something. I know that when we had interesting feedback from customers who started using auto-steer systems, and I like this feedback particularly because they say that, yeah, you have a lot of benefits from start using auto-steer system, but there is also drawbacks. And the drawback was that person started to smoke more because he had free hands and more time. So please don't smoke. Smoke is bad. Smoking is bad. Yeah, I feel that maybe we don't have questions for now. And as I mentioned, we really want to for farmers to comment and talk about these topics between you. And maybe for now, we will allow you this opportunity in our Facebook group. So you can join this. We will send you invitation, and we can share also your particular insights and questions. Please ask questions on things, and we will try to help you with figuring out what exactly the benefits of auto-steer system for you. So do we have some slides left, Martin? I think, yes, about the next webinar, yeah? So, as we mentioned, and I want to finish that we launched this Precision Academy, as we called it. We actually searched for similar things online, and we didn't find anything. So there is, basically, there is no any sources for farmers that you can learn about precision farming and study this topic more. And this topic definitely requires some education, study, experiments from you. So some effort, because it's not yes, something straightforward. It requires adoption and change your processes, things how you do business. So as well, it requires some time. And we know that we get a lot of orders last year, at the end of the year, and now many farmers, they got their new auto steers and new manual guidances, and therefore they have a lot of questions how to install a field bee system on their tractors. And that's why next webinar, that will be on the February 4th, we will invite our technical team, and our technical team will present how to install auto-steer system by yourself. So we invite you, and if you don't have our product, it will be still, I think, insightful for you, because you can learn in general how systems are organized, how they their parts, and how they connect with each other and with your tractor. So I think it will be also very insightful for you. So thank you for today, and for everyone who joined the webinar. It's always nice when you make time for this, and also for everyone who will be watching in it in recording, and hope to see you in next webinar. Thank you very much, Metin, as well, for your work. It was a lot of work done to prepare this webinar, and everyone who organized this. Thanks. Bye. Wish you a good day.
Thank you very much, everyone. Just to share Excel file. So if you contact via email to us, so we will share it with you for your own calculations.